This is the 2020 monsoon outlook for the state of Arizona, presented to you by the National Weather Service offices in Phoenix, Tucson, Flagstaff, and Las Vegas. We'll start by taking a look back at the 2019 monsoon season. Last year, weakening El Nino conditions caused a persistent trough pattern that lasted well into the summer months and resulted in a lack of northward moisture intrusions into the state. Not only was the 2019 season late to start, it ended up being the ninth driest season on record, with most places in Arizona seeing below average rainfall. Last year was also the third warmest monsoon season on record, with most areas seeing above average temperatures. What's a typical monsoon season like? The average amount of rainfall we get each year ranges drastically from the deserts to the mountains. The Phoenix area usually sees between 2 to 4 inches of rainfall during the monsoon season, but areas like Tucson in southern Arizona and Flagstaff in the mountains of northern Arizona see more like 6 to 8 inches of rain during monsoon season. Put simply, this is because mountains serve as an extra lifting mechanism, making it easier for thunderstorms to develop in the mountains. Another way to look at monsoon season is by the number of days with rain. This also varies considerably depending on the location. Areas along the Mogollon Rim to the White Mountains and portions of the higher terrain in southern Arizona see anywhere from 35 to 50 days of rain throughout the season, whereas the lower elevations across much of central and western Arizona, including the Phoenix area, only see about an average of 10 days or so with measurable rainfall. Breaking it down by month, the bulk of the precipitation occurs during the months of July and August, with precipitation diminishing during the month of September when the monsoonal circulation gradually wanes. About 30 to 60% of the state's annual precipitation falls during monsoon season. For southern and eastern Arizona, over half of the annual precipitation occurs during the monsoon season. For locales further to the north and west, where more winter precipitation occurs, the percent of annual precipitation that falls during the monsoon is closer to 30%. The state of Arizona averages over 500,000 lightning strikes in a single monsoon season. This lightning flash density map shows a nice correlation between the mountainous terrain and a higher density of lightning strikes, along with generally higher lightning numbers across far southern Arizona. Last year, with a weakening El Nino, the odds were pointed towards a later and drier than normal monsoon season. With a neutral El Nino and southern oscillation state this year, we lack any clear signal for monsoon season rainfall. The Climate Prediction Center outlooks show equal chances of having below, normal, or above normal rainfall this year. Another way to think about this is by looking at a dartboard. When throwing darts, without any expertise in aim, there's a random but equal chance of what color the dart will land on. The same can be said for the summer precipitation forecast this year. We have equal chances of being in any category. However, there's a more clear signal with temperature forecast this year. Odds favor warmer than normal temperatures across much of the western United States, including Arizona this monsoon season. There are many factors that go into creating a monsoon forecast. In addition to a neutral El Nino southern oscillation state giving no clear precipitation signal, we also look to climate modeling for seasonal forecasts. These are also showing little signal for precipitation. Given that much of Arizona was so dry last monsoon season, the likelihood remains very high that it will be wetter than last year. Arizona monsoon seasons vary dramatically from year to year, but regardless of a wet or dry season, Arizona will see areas of flash flooding, damaging thunderstorm winds, dust storms, hail, and lightning. It's best to be prepared for all of these monsoon hazards. Always check the latest forecasts before venturing outside, and be sure to have a good resource for receiving weather warnings. You can learn more during our upcoming Monsoon Awareness Week, June 14th through 20th. Each day during the week, we'll feature more information about a different monsoon season hazard. Be sure to follow us on our social media channels for the latest. Thanks for watching.